Okay, welcome back. Today we are going to cover another very important landmark judgment, that is Madhav Jivaji Rao Sindhia versus Union of India 1970. It is famously known as the Privy Purse case. I will be talking about Article 18, that is the abolition of the titles, 26th Amendment Act 1971 we will be going through, and also Article 291 and Article 366 Subclause 22, we will be covering all these things, okay? But before I proceed, please subscribe the channel so that you can get the updates regularly. And at the right top corner, there is an I button. Just click on that and you will get the links for the judgments, which I have already uploaded right from 1950 till 2020. And other general studies material also in different playlists are given, okay? So let's proceed with the judgment. Now, this is the Madhav Jivaji Rao Sindhia versus Union of India, and this is the bench. You can see Honorable Justice Hidayatullah, Honorable Justice Shah, Honorable Justice Sikri, and you can just read out here. This is the bench actually who have delivered the judgment, but we will see what was the actual fact, okay? So let's proceed. So basically this case is dealing with Article 18 also, that is the abolition of the titles. You can see it in the Constitution of India. You can read it there, and after completing the judgment, then things will be almost clear to you, all of you, okay? So first of all, we will talk about the validity of the abolition of the Privy Purse by the presidential order. What actually happened in the present case was whether the act of the president or that presidential order was there, which actually de-recognized the rulers from getting the Privy Purse. So whether it is an unconstitutional, whether it was ultra vires, beyond the scope of the Constitution, or it can it be declared as a null and void? Can it be declared as a null and void? So there was a presidential order which actually related to this privy purse, and let me tell you one thing, there was a revenue deficit also. So revenue deficit was increasing, and if by the virtue of the Privy Purse the rulers were given a kind of a pension or some amount which was given to them annually or maybe monthly, so this amount was given to them, and in lieu of that or in consideration of that, they were actually having a kind of a agreement, and according to that agreement, they have to join the union of India, okay? So I will be talking about that. I should not be very fast. So this is the, first of all, you must be clear with the issue. The issue here is that whether the act of the president de-recognizing the ruler from getting the Privy Purse is unconstitutional, ultra vires, or void or not. So here, let's come to the fact and see what was the actually story. So, you know, after the independence, after the passage of the this Indian Independence Act 1947, when this came, so after the passage of this, you can say, act, the British government granted the independence to the area that were directly under their rule of the British people. And at that point of time, you know, it was the British India, and there were so many princely states. So what happened after coming of this act, the British, control over our territories. So it was the, at that point of time, the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel ji persuaded all these princely state, inko sabko persuade kiya, unhone manaya, ki please join the Indian Union, means the Union of India, please be the part of the Union of India, and please do away with all the titles which you are holding, rather you please become the part of the Union of India. So after the independence, it was very, very important. Otherwise, we have to unite all these things, na? Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel initiative was there, and he actually persuaded all these princely states to join the Indian Union. Now, in the lieu, I have already explained that, but in the lieu or in the consideration of that, these princely state signing an instrument of accession, you can say kind of agreement was signed between them, and the government of India granted them a Privy Purse. Now, what is the Privy Purse? So it was nothing but a kind of a pension, a kind of a sum payable or a money to be given or payable annually to these these kings specifically, to these pocket, these areas of these princely states, obviously. So this was actually what was the story, एंड यू जस्ट गो एंड सी द इंटरप्रिटेशन द डेफिनेशन definition the article the interpretation you can say which is given in article 366 so several number of clauses are there you go and today you just check the constitution of India so you will find that there is an article 366 and you specifically go to the article 366 sub clause 22 of the Indian constitution 1949 just read if you have the Brayer Act so there you will find that it reads as or just have a cursory reading of this article, we find that the ruler, this ruler means the prince or the chief or other persons who, at the time before the commencement of this constitution, 26th Amendment Act 1971, इसके बारे में मैं बाद में बात करूँगा, ये जो आपका 26वां जो अमेंडमेंट एक्ट है 1971 का 1971 का इसको हम लास्ट में आई विल बी कवरिंग सो इससे पहले आफ्टर कमेंसमेंट ऑफ दिस बिफोर द मींस द पर्सन हु एट द टाइम बिफोर द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन 26th अमेंडमेंट इस एक्ट के आने से पहले वॉज एक्चुअली रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाई द ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट ऑब्वियसली ऑफ आवर इंडिया एज अ रूलर ऑफ द इंडियन स्टेट तो उनको रिकॉग्नाइज किया गया था और एनी पर्सन हु एट द टाइम बिफोर द कमेंसमेंट ऑफ दिस एक्ट ऑब्वियसली वॉज रिकॉग्नाइज बाई द प्रेसिडेंट एज अ सक्सेसर ऑफ सच रूलर्स तो दिस वॉज एक्चुअली गिवन एंड दिस रिकॉग्निशन वॉज गिवन टू ऑल दोज पीपल ठीक है ऑल दोज पीपल एंड बाई द वर्च्यू ऑफ दिस आर्टिकल बाई द ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ आवर इंडिया सो दिस वॉज द थिंग So now, in the exercise of the power vested in him, means obviously the President, under Article 366, Subclause 22 of the Constitution of India, the Honorable President hereby direct that, with the effect from the date of this order, His Highness, Maharaja Dhiraj Madhav Rao Jivaji Rao Sindhya, ceases to be the ruler of Gwalior. Similar orders were communicated to all the rulers also. Means, by the virtue of this article, earlier they will be recognized, But later on, again by the virtue of the same article and by the presidential order, it was declared, and so all means to all the princely state, it was declared that whosoever was a king or a small the ruler or whosoever the person who is holding some kind of title also, so everything and even the right from the date of this jo order the presidential order tha with the effect from the date of this order jo us pe order pe jo date hai tab se they will be ceased to be the ruler wo ruler nahi rahenge and specifically we are talking about this madhav the highness madhav maharaja dhiraj madhav rao jivaji sindhya case so here he was ruler of the gwalior so again you can better understand now what was the consequence so there was so much of hue and cry and they filed a you know they reached to the court doors of they started knocking the doors of the court you can say and so many truckload of cases started coming to the courts also so this was the basic thing and now what the contention the government was putting forward it was that first the privy purse agar if you read the article 291 just read it if you have the Brayer Act so this was actually regarding the privy purse so it actually did not impose any kind of obligation upon the union of india to pay the privy purse means this annual sum of actually as per the accession there was an agreement so they must pay to these rulers or the kings because they have there was an agreement between the union of india as well as these kings So, in the lieu of that agreement, they were actually getting the consideration or some amount of money to be payable as a pension, you can say. So by this presidential order, and presidential order was challenged in the court, so the government was giving the contention that obviously they are under the obligation. As far as the revenue deficit of the government is that, it is too high. Means the income is very less and expenditure is very high, so if they will be giving a lot of payment or any kind of expenditure because the socio-economic reforms and other reforms were also in parallel going on. So at the same time, if they are giving such kind of payments or annually they are paying to these rulers, so now it should be removed, it should be abolished because it is now getting a burden upon the state or the exchequer. So it was the contention, okay? So now Article 291 and 362 of the Constitution did not vest any, the petitioners are not having any kind of right or they cannot enforce, they cannot go to the courts of law for the enforcement of such kind of rights. Means these articles are not vesting the petitioner with the right to, right of enforcement of these kind of rights, jo humne agreement mein kiya hai. So it was a contention of the government, okay. So as I have already said, it is popularly known as the privy purse case. So it was held that. It was held, now we are coming to the conclusion, it was held that the order of the Honorable President of India डायरेक्टिंग द माधव राव जीवाजी सिंधिया ओबियसली वुड सीज टू बी रिकोगनाइज एज अ रूलर ऑफ द ग्वालियर ऑन एंड विद इफेक्ट फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ द सेड ऑर्डर वॉज अल्ट्रा वॉयस मीन्स इट इज़ बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इट इज़ डिक्लेयर टू बी नल एंड वॉइड. तो उन्होंने इस केस में अभी देखिए दिस इज नाउ गेटिंग अप अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट. What is happening? They have said that no, you cannot by means of putting the presidential order take away the right to get themselves maintained by the virtue of the privy purse. So you cannot do that. They have declared it, as a unconstitutional. You can say ultra vires beyond the constitution, beyond the scope of the constitution. So they have declared. Now the declaration of the law resulted in the restoration of the privy purses received by the rulers and also ensured continuation of their personal privileges. So all those privileges were restored, and obviously privy purse was whatever the things they were receiving, they were they restored again, and the restoration was there. And the Honorable Supreme Court of India in this case held that 1970 presidential order was invalid. So they have declared ki wo invalid ho gaya. Now see what was the aftermath of the judgment. But now the government has to do away, means they were actually trying to do away with this kind of expenditures. And obviously government is always have the power, they have the power to amend the constitution, and they can make necessary changes as far as the development is concerned, economy is concerned, and what is suitable for the citizens of India. So they have right to amend or right to come up with any kind of amendment. So now what happened finally for the holistic development, obviously welfare of the people. Now the then Prime Minister at that time, Miss Indira Gandhi, argued the case, or she was actually saying that the case for the abolition of the privy purse is very important. So they came up with the 26th Amendment Act 1971, obviously, and this amendment to the Constitution of India was there. It is by the virtue of this amendment, 26th Amendment Act 1971, the privy purse was abolished. It was puri tarah se phir abolish kar diya gaya. Obviously, it is in the hand of government. They have right to do that. They can do that. They have their, it's a prerogative of the government to do that. Come up, they can obviously do this by the virtue of the amendment powers. So they came up with this act. And the amendment lead to the omission of Article 291 and 362. So, इसको omit कर दिया गया. तो आज if you have the BEAR Act, please open it and you will see this 291, and you just go to the footnotes, you will find that 26th Amendment Act 1971 is written. That means that has been abolished. Okay. And however, after the 26th Amendment to the Constitution of India, the Government of India abolished the all official symbols of the princely India, obviously, including the title, privileges, remuneration, privy purses, and all. So all the things were abolished. This is what the abolition of the titles, Article 18, talks about. Okay, so one reason, there are a few reasons, so we talk about the reasons as I have already talking about. So revenue deficit, so total revenue received jo hame prapt hota hai minus total expenditure jo hum ghatate hain, so that is the revenue deficit or the revenue deficit. So the then Prime Minister Miss Indira Gandhi ma'am argued that the case for the abolition of the privy purse based on the equal rights for all the citizens and the need to reduce the government revenue deficit. So it was very important judgment. I have sufficiently tried to make you people clear the crux of the judgment. If you liked it, please mention in the comment box sections. If you need any improvement in the explanation, or if I am so fast, please tell me so that I can improvise. And God bless to everybody of you. Okay, thanks, and please subscribe the channel. All the very best.